Alright guys, I've got a couple of encounters that's going to come to you from Michigan. Michigan seems to be a pretty hot spot for these creatures, so if you was interested in investigating them, I think Michigan might be a good place to start. This happened at Big Rapids, Michigan in 1961. The gentleman that had this encounter says he allegedly captured a photograph of this upright canid cryptid. It was the year 1961, though the anonymous narrator fails to specify which month it is. It was around 3 in the morning in the Michigan town of Big Rapids, where the unknown source was up late at night at his home. He lived right across from the manufacturing plant that he worked at as a night watchman. The plant sat right next to the Haymarsh State game area, and this is where the source claims to have seen someone or something making noise by the chain-link fence boarding the property. Thinking it was an intruder, the narrator goes from his work to his house to grab a gun. But when he returns outside, he instead sees a 6-foot-tall, grayish-brownish upright canid shambling about in his driveway, thinking quickly on his feet. The anonymous source rushes to his house to try and grab his camera. Instead, when he returns outside, the dogman was already out of the driveway, further into the dark street. However, at one point, the creature did move near a street light where the anonymous source was able to snap one of maybe 4 or 5 alleged photographs that have never been shown. The Michigan dogman then ran away that night. You know, I don't think it's that rare for you to have an encounter in town. We know that our last guest we had on, Jody, he had an encounter in town where they were beating and scratching on his house and standing underneath the street light also. You know, street lights, they attract bugs, which attracts animals, and may be a place that they hang out to try to catch prey. Armadillos, possums, and other animals of the sort, foxes, will sometimes eat underneath the street lights that, of course, draw the bugs. This happened in 1988, and I hope I pronounce this right, in Alto and Lowell, Michigan. The story is remarkable, and such as the details of a man who claims that a dogman had followed him since he was young, with 2 separate encounters spanning 20 years apart. The first one takes place in 1988 in Alto, Michigan, just southeast of the city of Grand Rapids. The anonymous source, an elementary school at the time, was playing during recess. Around 10 in the morning, he decided to run out into the woods adjacent to the elementary school playground to hide and also cheat at the game of war. He made his way to the river by some train tracks when he heard a huge splash and witnessed a dark-furred dogman bolt into the woods, switching between 2 and 4 legs to run before disappearing. At this point, the kid ran straight home to his bed, keeping silent about his sighting until adulthood. He described it as an 80-ish feet tall, 300-pound, blue-eyed, this time, and seeming almost like a timber wolf, but upright and with longer legs. The second sighting took place in the nearby town of Lowell in the winter of 2008. The anonymous man now has a family, all sleeping soundly, when he heard the thud on the roof. His canine-related childhood memories immediately flooded back. Without prompting, he quietly snuck outside, and that is when the very same blue-eyed dogman poked his head out from the top of the roof, staring directly at him. Then the dogman leaped 30 feet from the roof and bolted on all fours to the tree line, only to stand up and stare at the anonymous man for a full minute. The man then ran toward the dogman with a machete that he had purchased. The dogman just stared at him, almost grinning now, before uttering a single audible word. It spoke, guys. It said, "Don't." The man stopped dead in his tracks and was overwhelmed by a supreme weird sense of calm. He dropped his machete and backed away. The dogman stood on its hind legs, walked into the woods, disappearing, never to be seen again. You know, guys, this brought 3 things to mind to me. There was one time whenever I was out doing an investigation under a bridge, and I heard a large splash, which was a rock that landed in the creek beside me. It was a rather large rock, and I think I named that one, if you want to go back and watch it, "It Tried to Hurt Me," or something like that. Another thing that really grabbed my attention about this, well, is how it was on the roof. It used to be on the roof at my grandma's house. And I think the reason they do that is they can hide up there, they can lean over the roof, look in the windows, knock on the windows, and Well, we couldn't figure out one night how it was knocking on the door and we couldn't see it. Until my uncle said, look, the knuckles are upside down. And he looked and saw it laying up in the darkness on top of the porch. These things are clever and they're very smart. But another thing that it done that I also caught in this that really got me was it spoke. Now we did hear it speak many times, not as often as we heard the sounds of grunting and the gambling and the scratching on things, but they do speak. And most of the time when they speak, it is just one word, usually a name. That is another weird thing that they do, and they also like to mimic noises that you use around the house. Guys, I hope you enjoyed this. If you haven't subscribed, I would like to encourage you to please reach down, hit the subscribe button, ring the bell, select all to get all of our latest content that's coming. There's going to be a lot more boots on the ground, a lot more encounters that are going to be shared. Plus, if you'll hit that like button, it also helps put us out on the algorithm, which helps our videos get out to everyone, and which helps us grow. We would appreciate that very much, and again, would welcome you to become part of our family. Until next time, guys, keep your head on a swivel, don't be something's dinner, and thank you very much for your support.